Within the cells of our body, the pH ranges from about 6.8 to about 7.4. So based on that information, we can say that the average pH of our cells is around 7. Now the question is, why exactly do the cells in our body spend so much energy trying to maintain a constant pH of 7? And more specifically, how exactly does changing the pH inside our cells affect the many different types of biological processes and reactions that take place within those cells? Now, what we're going to focus on in this lecture is how increasing the pH inside our nucleus of the cell actually changes the structure of the DNA, how it affects the double helix structure of the DNA, the formation of the double helix. So let's begin by looking at the following diagram that basically describes the relationship between the pH change and the structure of our DNA. So the x-axis is the intracellular pH, the pH inside the cell, and as we go from left to right, the pH increases. Now the y-axis describes the percentage of the DNA molecules that exist in their double helix form. So what exactly does this graph actually tell us? Well, we see that at a pH of 7, at a normal pH of 7, all the DNA molecules, 100% of these DNA molecules in the nucleus exist in their double helix form. Now, as we begin to add a few drops of hydroxide ions, we begin to increase our pH. Now, initially, what happens to our percentage of those molecules that exist in their double helix form? Well, initially, the slope is essentially flat. So what that means, the slope is essentially zero, and initially, changing the pH doesn't really change the amount of DNA molecules that exist in their double helix form. But as we approach a pH of 9, what we see happen is the slope becomes much more steep and much more negative. And so what that means is between the 9 and 10 pH values, a small change in the pH in the X value creates a very large change in the Y value. And so the majority of those DNA molecules actually break down and dissociate into their single strand form between the pH 9 and pH 10, between this range. And by the time we get to a pH of 10, we see that less than 10% of those DNA molecules inside the nucleus actually exist in their double helix form. So we see that by increasing the pH or decreasing the pH, which is not shown in this diagram, our DNA molecules begin to break down into their single strand form. The question is why? Why does this actually take place, and how does the pH actually affect that structure of the DNA molecule? So let's begin by recalling what Ka and pKa is with respect to some hypothetical acid. So let's suppose we have the following acid, and we know that the acid dissociates into the H plus ion and its conjugate base. Now, from basic chemistry, we know that the equilibrium constant expression for this particular reaction is given by this equation. So the Ka, the acid dissociation constant Ka, is equal to the product of the concentration of these two products divided by the concentration of this acid. Now, what exactly does the Ka tell us about the acid? Well, the Ka is nothing but a ratio between the concentration of the products and the concentration of the reactants. So the greater the Ka is, the greater our numerator is, and the more products we form. And if we form more products, if we form more H plus ion, that means the acid is a much stronger acid. And so we can say that a higher Ka value means more of these H plus ions are produced, and the stronger the acid is. And the stronger the acid is, the more likely it will dissociate and give off and donate that H plus ion. Now, normally in chemistry, instead of using Ka to basically describe the strength of that acid, we use something else called the pKa. And the relation between pKa and Ka is given by this equation. So pKa is equal to the negative log of the Ka. So from this relation, we see that the greater the Ka value is, the smaller the pKa is. And likewise, the smaller the K is, the greater the pKa is. So we see that the greater the Ka is, the smaller the pKa is, and the better that acid is, the more likely that it will donate that H plus ion. And likewise, the smaller our Ka is, the larger the pKa is, and the less likely our acid will actually donate that H plus ion. So a smaller pKa means the acid is strong and it will be very likely to donate that H plus ion. So that is what we mean by the pKa. The pKa basically is used to describe the strength of that acid. Now, what are the acids that exist within our DNA? Well, if we actually examine the bases within our double helix structure, some of the bases can act as acids. So let's take a look at guanine, for example. This hydrogen attached to this nitrogen can actually act as an acid. And what that means is, at a certain particular pH, it will begin to dissociate and give off that H. And when it dissociates, it forms the deprotonated version of guanine, in which this H has been removed and the two electrons in that covalent bond have now gone onto that nitrogen. And so we produce a negative charge here and a positive charge here. And this is basically equivalent to this equation here, where the H is this H here, and the A is this entire molecule here, and the HA is this molecule here. But for this particular reaction, the pKa is equal to 9.7. Now, what 9.7 means is it's a relatively large value, it's relatively positive, and so this isn't a very good acid. But if the pH is driven high enough, it will become a good acid in the sense that it will readily dissociate and give off that H atom. Now, why is that a problem? Well, that's a problem because this H atom actually associates with the other complementary base to form a hydrogen bond. And the hydrogen bonds within our DNA hold the two strands of DNA together. Now, before we examine that in more detail, let's answer the following question. So, what can we say about guanine when the pH inside our nucleus of the cell is equal to the pKa of the guanine molecule? So let's suppose we look at the following curve, and along the curve, if we examine the pH of pKa of 9.7, so if we're somewhere here, we see that the majority of these DNA molecules have dissociated. Why? Well, to answer this question, let's actually set these two equal to each other. So we know that the pH of our solution is equal to pKa. Now, pKa is equal to this equation, negative log of Ka. And Ka is equal to the ratio of these two. And so if we plug in the right side into the Ka here, on the right side of this equation, we basically get this. So negative log of Ka, and Ka is equal to this ratio. So we replace Ka with this ratio. Now, what is the pH? Well, pH by definition is equal to the negative log of the concentration of the hydrogen ion. So we replace pH with this. Now, algebraically, we see that on both sides, we have a negative, and so we multiply both sides by negative 1 to cancel that negative. And we also see on both sides, we have the log function. So if we raise both of these to the power of 10, or actually if we do this, we see that the log will basically cancel out. And so all we get is this concentration of the hydrogen ion is equal to the ratio of these two guys. And so we see that the negatives cancel and the logs cancel, and we're simply left with this relationship. So the concentration of our hydrogen ion, this is equal to the product of the concentration of the H plus ion and the A divided by the concentration of HA. So the H plus appears on both sides, and so we can cancel that out. And then if we bring this side to the left, this denominator to the left side, we get the following equality. So we see that when the pH is equal to the pKa, when the pH of our solution inside the cell is equal to 9.7, so somewhere about here, we see that the concentration of the HA is equal to the concentration of the A. Now, what is HA in this case? Well, HA, we said, is the guanine. And our A is basically this deprotonated guanine. So we see that at a pH of 9.7, so this is about 9.7, we see that exactly half of the guanine molecules within the DNA are going to be deprotonated. Now, why is that bad? Well, that's bad because there is this hydrogen bond that exists between this H atom and this nitrogen atom of the complementary base, cytosine. And if we remove this H, then we basically disrupt that hydrogen bond. The hydrogen bond cannot form. In fact, we have a negative charge here and a partially negative charge here, and those two like charges will basically repel one another. And so what happens is they will begin to dissociate, and that's exactly why at around this range, we see a tremendous decrease in the number of DNA molecules that exist in the double helix form, because around this pH, half of these guanine have lost their H and have been deprotonated, and now they cannot form those stabilizing hydrogen bonds. So when the pH of the cell equals the pKa of guanine, so when the pH is 9.7, the concentration of the protonated guanine will equal to the concentration of deprotonated guanine. That is, exactly half of the guanine bases will be deprotonated. Now, that's a problem because guanine participates in hydrogen bonds, which are responsible for holding the two strands of DNA together. And as we increase the pH, we basically decrease the amount of H bonds because we decrease the number of H atoms on the guanine, and that destabilizes that entire double helix structure of DNA. And so within this range, we see this very drastic decrease in the number of DNA molecules that exist in a double helix form because all those guanine molecules lose that H atom. So we see within this range, we have a very, very drastic change in the Y value, in the percent of those DNA molecules that exist in the double helix form. So we see that this is precisely why the cells of our body spend so much energy trying to maintain a constant pH value, because decreasing or increasing the pH will affect all the different types of biological processes that take place inside our cells. Now, by the way, in this case, in this example, we focused on increasing our pH, but the same effect or similar effect is seen if we decrease the pH. If we decrease the pH, then what we end up doing is we end up protonating some of those atoms that are involved in forming hydrogen bonds, and that also disrupts our bonding between the two strands of DNA. So not only will increasing the pH disrupt the double structure of the DNA, but also decreasing the pH will have the same similar effect on the structure of the DNA.